Hi there, welcome to this physio. Today Jack and myself are going to go through some exercises to help you improve your turn and your backswing. Right, so this is the first in a four-part set of episodes that we're going to do. And we're going to have a look at some of the musculature and the setup that make up your spine and how we can improve some of the bits around that to improve your backswing. So firstly, we're going to have a look at the lats. So if Jack just turns side on here, the lats, big muscle in your back that connects to the back of your shoulder all the way down into your hip. They're crucial for your golf swing because as they connect to your hip, if they get short and tight, they're going to stop you being able to turn on the way back and you'll lose your posture and that rotation on the way down. So first things first, we're going to use what we call a pin-up. So I've asked Jack to lie on the floor. And we're just going to get this peanut, we're going to put it right on his lats here. So Jack's going to lie on his side, he's going to get the peanut, he's going to place it under his lats here with his arm outstretched above his head and thumb up to the ceiling. So in this position here, I just want to ask Jack to rock backwards and forwards. I'd start with the peanut just level with your bottom of your shoulder blade here. And we're going to work all the way up into your armpit. We're just trying to improve the blood flow into that muscle. We're trying to get it a bit more malleable, which will give you the ability to stretch and turn in your backswing. So Jack's just going to rock back and forth three times, and then he's going to work up. So just move the pin up a bit, Jack, maybe up a rib or two. Keep that thumb up to the ceiling. We're keeping our arms stretched above our head. Good, we're just trying to improve the quality of that soft tissue. And Jack's going to work this back and forth all the way up into his armpit. So Jack's going to jump back up onto his feet. Once we've done that, we're going to have a look at the front of our body now. So we're going to have a look at the pec. The pec attaches into your shoulder here and it pulls everything forward if it gets short and tight. And you can see how my posture's changed immediately. So what we want to do is loosen this soft tissue up here, which is going to allow us to put the shoulder back into a really good position to help us set in a lovely posture over the ball. So what Jack's going to do is going to get the ball here. You come over here, Jack. You're just going to clamp the ball with your arm behind your back, your shoulder set backwards, and you're going to clamp the ball between yourself and a rack or a wall, any upright that's nice and firm. So if you go there, Jack. So his arm's in a lovely position behind his back here, his shoulder's nice and quiet, not jammed forward. It's in a really good postural position there. From there, Jack's just going to rock up, down, left, right, side to side. He's going to work that ball around all those fibres of his pec. These fibres get tight when you sat in the car or you sat at your desk at work or just generally slouched in the chair at home watching the TV. So after he's done a few up and down, Jack, I just want you to twist the ball whilst keeping that pressure on. That's just going to put a bit more tension through your fascia there. You might feel a little bit more comfortable, but that's just going to add a little bit more. You're going to get deeper into those tissue fibres. You're going to put them under more stretch. So Jack's going to do that for five twists on each pec, and then we'll move on to some stretching. Thank you for watching. If you did enjoy the video, please subscribe to us on YouTube or like through my website, the link is above. The next episode, we're going to have a look at some thoracic extension and give the exercises a go and let us know any feedback in the comments.